Today we go back to our roots. Today we do the Peranakan food. The Peranakan food is a Malay and a Chinese mix. It is the early signs of racial harmony. So this Candle Nut Peranakan restaurant, they are very clever. They take the traditional Peranakan food, modernize it, and come up with new style.
This is the Wakula Wagyu beef. For people who don't know what is Wakula, right? It's actually a black nut. It's an essential ingredient in all Peranakan food. Usually they serve you chicken or stuffed meat. So why do you choose Wagyu beef when normally it's chicken?
Because I personally like beef. I like the flavour that you can pair with the bokolo.
But let me just tell you something before I eat. It's not very food porn worthy for photo. Because all like that. But do not be deceived by black like that. It can taste good.
It's an Asian truffle.
Ah, that's a good description. Right. So everybody, from now on, we will know Wakula as Asian truffles.
Yes. We soak the nuts for a minimum of 5 days, and then we knock the nuts, extract it, and then we have the paste ready for cooking. The meat is brined separately, sous vide, so that retains a lot of the texture and the flavour.
So for those of you who are coming to eat, can you please lick up the sauce?
Yes.
Mmm. So the sauce, right, is a little bit spicy. You blend the Wakula.
Because when we take out, there's a lot of shells.
But I find that the sauce is too blended for me. On one hand, it's so much more convenient, you don't have to dig. But on the other hand, the whole joy about eating Wakula is also the dig part. You know, like old people, we all like to have the nutty bite into the Wakula because it's after all a real nut, right? Because he blend it, so you don't get the nutty, bitter bite. But the good thing is, there's not going to be any like small little shells stuck within your teeth. Verdict for the beef. It's very tender, beefy, but it's not chunky, it's got little strips. I like the little strips part. Especially you guys out there who like beef or wagyu beef, you will love this dish. For me, I can just eat the sauce with the rice. Mmm.
Usually in Peranakan restaurants, they will do prawn nanas, they will do the asam prawn. But this is the first time in my life, I'm going to try a Gula Melaka prawn. So what is Gula Melaka? Gula Melaka is a palm sugar that is normally used in desserts. I don't know why this chef go and put into the prawn. Don't know whether it will spoil my prawn or not. Explain yourself.
You always add a bit of sugar to balance the flavour. And why not use Gula Melaka? Because it is also sweet. It's a coconut origin. So this whole dish is a very good representation of the different flavours of coconut.
But how do you actually prepare this dish?
We just do an oil blanching method, which is basically just to put it through a very hot oil to set the texture and the shape. And finally, we will just finish off the prawns in the sauce.
It's so stingy. It's so little.
It's a very rich sauce.
And so it's very thick. It smells very, very good. It's got a very light coconutty smell. Very good. The sauce is very good. I bite that time, still have the coconut.
Yes, we have lemongrass, fresh herbs, coconut milk and roasted coconut in the sauce.
It's not too spicy. Yep. I think it's very good for people like me who are not good with spices. Remember the episode that I have to do all the spices? I find it very interesting because it is thick but yet it's light. I expected the Gula Melaka to be very sweet, but it's not so sweet. It actually adds a little smoky taste into the sauce. Gives it more character, right? Damn shook. Let's try the prawn now, okay? You know a lot of people, they don't know the best part of the prawn is the head. That's only relevant if the prawn is fresh. When you suck in, right, it's succulent one. So confirm, the prawn is fresh. I really like the texture. It's very al dente, crunchy one. And then it's juicy on the inside. It's quite a successful invention, you know? Apa ini? You call this a dessert?
Yes.
On the outside, it looks like a normal chocolate ice cream, but actually it's the Wakula ice cream. It is made with Wakula paste and Verona chocolate, served on a bit of salted caramel, then topped with chili specks, crackling chocolate crumble, the Wakula ice cream, and warm milk chocolate sauce. How do you even come up with this crazy idea? It's very strange to put Wakula into ice cream.
It is. I love Wakula. When I cook it, you know, the smell that comes out is a bit of that chocolate smell. So that's where the inspiration came from, that, oh wow, I can actually try to use it like a chocolate. Try the ice cream first, and then later as a combination.
The texture is like durian. Can I now try with the chocolate already?
Please go ahead.
This is very bitter.
Now you try as a combination. It's meant to be a composed dessert as a whole.
It's a very complex dessert, you know. Very interesting, salty and sweet taste. Caramelish, kind of sweet, salty and bitter. Yeah. Salty, sweet, bitter. Oh, you know, tastes like bitter durian that is a dark chocolate. Can you just imagine a dark chocolate that is like a bitter durian? It's very complicated. This is a combustion of complication. Actually,
Do you notice that the ice cream never melt one? What kind of 神奇 ice cream is this?
It doesn't melt because there's a very high bokkola content in it. The paste holds everything together.
Is it strange? I really think you must come and try yourself, you know. And then please, like, Instagram us or tag us and let us know your feeling. Because I really like bokkola and I like the bokkola part of it and I also like the chocolate, but put together, it is too new age. Too out there for me and for old people. That's it for this very sedap episode, and the good people of Candlenut is giving away two $50 vouchers. And if you would like to win, please leave a comment with a registered Click Network account and we will pick the two lucky winners. If you know of any food that we should feature on this show, please leave a comment or tag us on your Instagram with the hashtag ClickNetworkFoodPod. And also, if you have not already done so, please download our Click Network application, which is free for Apple and Android and also Xiaomi users. Bye-bye!